Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Wally McGee My Career series here in NBA 2K16 on the PS4. The Minnesota Timberwolves are only 11-20, but they have won two games in a row, trying to make that three as the Indiana Pacers come to town. See back-to-back nights here playing Indiana and then Oklahoma City on the road. The nice thing that we opened up in the last episode by meeting with the team owner is the ability to select our own jerseys now, not only for us, but for the visiting team. So I finally get to get Wally in those alternate black uniforms. I've been kind of waiting for some variety here for quite a while, and now we finally get to do that. So having selected our uniforms for tonight, let's see if they bring us any luck. Indiana missing a basket right there, and Wally's going to get a rebound. Pushing this the other way. He's going to throw the alley-oop pass. Looks like it may have been tipped, but Andrew Wiggins is able to finish. Wally does not get credit for an assist right here, which is kind of too bad and a little puzzling, but I guess maybe he got a fingertip on that and it canceled it. Anyway, he does have the one rebound, and here's Shabazz Muhammad getting a rebound, pushing this down the floor to Wally. Wally, quick pass to Wiggins, and Wiggins finishes on the fast break. So that's officially his first assist. They won't take that one away from him. And we move further in here. 15-14, Minnesota with the lead. Wally looking for a spot to take his jumper, and he will hit it. So his first 2 points of the game. He now goes to the bench in a 19-16 lead as the first quarter is winding down. When he comes back, it's a 25-22 Timberwolves lead in the second quarter. Able to make another jumper right there. He now has 4 points to go along with his one assist and one rebound. Looking to get an open shot off again. No, instead he passes off, and that'll be a bucket. Okay, Gorgui Dieng gets fouled there away from the play. Basket still counts, so got a 32-27 game, and there's Wally picking up another basket down low. 34-30, that shot is going to miss. It's a rebound by Karl Anthony Towns. Timberwolves want to push the pace. Wally to Shabazz Muhammad. He loses the handle, finds it in time to lay it up and in, and he will get credit for the assist right there. Interesting how sometimes this works and sometimes it doesn't in that regard. 36-32, Tyus Jones running out of room, but he does find an open Wally McGee, who draws a foul. He'll be going to the line for the first time here in the game, looking to sink 2 of 2. He makes the first and extends the lead 37-32. See if he can sink both of them. He does just that. So a 6-point lead now for the Timberwolves. And he goes and sits down at the bench as Indiana's cutting into the lead. Just a 1-point game right now. Pekovic is not able to make his shot. So we go to halftime, and it is a 46-43 Timberwolves lead at the break. Not a bad position to be in their quest for 3 straight victories. Definitely want to try to get any kind of winning streak they can get going on this season and get back to a respectable spot. Nice save there by the Indiana player, but it eventually ends up in the hands of Wally McGee, who knocks down an easy uncontested jumper. We're tied at 52 right now. Okay, here come the Pacers trying to take the lead back. That pass is going to be deflected and stolen by Karl Anthony Towns. Headmans out to Wally McGee with the fast break dunk. There you go, in transition once again. Wally getting out and running the floor, and it pays off as they find him for the easy basket. 54 all in the third quarter. Wally dribbling, finds Wiggins from three-point range, but he's going to move around, gives it back to Wally. These two work together so well, and there is another instance of it right there as Wally gets the bucket. Looks like KG hurt himself there. You see the injury marker coming up, but he's staying in the game. Wally, he's like, where's the foul? They just say out of bounds and no foul. Wally does not like the call right there, but that's what it's going to be. So he's got 14 points right now, 3 assists. You got another steal by the Timberwolves. Muhammad gets it to Wally McGee, and, well, no foul, but he also gets the bucket right there. He says, if I'm not going to get the calls from the ref, I'm just going to have to make sure I finish myself. So we're down 75-68 right now in the fourth quarter. That's a little concerning here. Got to pick up the pace. Wally finds Cat. And Towns is fouled. He cannot complete the and-one opportunity there, but he will go to the line. And we now have an 80-74 game. Just trying to cut back into this lead that Indiana has accumulated an offensive rebound credited to Wally, although he didn't hang on to it. Towns is the one that ends up with possession of the basketball, and he gets fouled. So he makes two shots. It's an 80-76 game. Wally McGee down the lane, and he is able to flush it home with the slam. Nice recognition there to get him the ball as he cut to the basket. He now has 18 points. Down five, it'd be very helpful if Indiana went cold shooting. No, they missed that one, and Rubio the rebound. Rubio looking to give to Wally McGee, who hits that jumper. He now has 20, and they are within three. Here come the Pacers, though. Oh, they lose the ball. Oh, careless play right there. And a zip pass into the lane, and a bucket. Shabazz Muhammad and the assist from Wally. It's just a one-point game now. Well, Pacers score again, and it's back to three. Moving this ball around, Wally gets it underneath. No, his shot does not go, but Karl Anthony Towns with the rebound and the emphatic dunk. Oh, he is fired up. He gets fouled on the play as well. We've got to see a replay here as Towns is just dominating down low, and a thunderous slam. Timberwolves hanging right in this one. You got an 87-86 game, under 4 minutes to play. Oh, it looked like it was going to be an easy basket, but no. Towns is able to make him adjust his shot a little bit and miss. So here we come with a chance to take the lead back. Muhammad's got the ball. Wally just trying to get into open space. He will finally just watch Shabazz Muhammad take the shot and knock it down. Clutch shot right there. And they're up one, 88-87. Here are the Pacers missing again. Another rebound, this time by Pekovic. Why is he taking it up the court? Get that to somebody who can handle. There you go. Getting the ball to Wally. Wally over to Shabazz Muhammad. Had an open three look, but he instead kicks it to Wiggins, who hits his open three. 91-87, timeout, Indiana, and they've got to regroup as we're now up 4 points. This one looks like it's going to be good down the stretch here in these final 3 minutes, trying to D up. Oh, he's going to drive, and no basket. Towns the rebound. Wiggins to Wally. Back to Shabazz Muhammad with the one-handed flush. Oh my goodness, great passing right there by the Timberwolves, and it ends up in a dunk. So 93-89 is the score. That's not going to be a bucket. Rebound Indiana, and here they come the other way. Fast break, and the bucket and the foul. Oh, the last thing you want to do if you're Wiggins is foul right there, as they're going to get a chance for the three-point play, which they get. It's just a one-point game now, minute 22 to play. Wally looking for some open space to help out Shabazz right here as he's basically doubled. Gets the ball to Wally. Layup is up and good. It's going to be another timeout for Indiana and another clutch bucket for Wally McGee. You see Wiggins fired up, as is the whole Minnesota bench. They can smell crunch time here and a possible third win in a row, which would be huge for a team that's 11-20. Knocked down right there, though. Pacers not going away. It's 95-94. About 30 seconds left. Wally trying to be patient with this. They want to get a good look. Getting this around. It's Wiggins. Wiggins to Wally McGee. He's not going to shoot. They pass this around. Shot clock is winding down. Wally gets it back to Gorgui Dieng. He's got to shoot. And it goes. Oh, what a huge bucket right there. Didn't know if he was going to make it, but it rolls inside the cylinder. 97-94. Timeout here for Indiana. And they get another opportunity to tie it up. Well, they go for two. They go for the quick two, and they're going to try to foul now or steal the inbounds. The ball gets into Wally McGee, and they have to foul him. So a 97-96 game. Wally to the line. He really needs to knock both these down. Hits the first one. It's a 98-96 game, but you want to make this one and force them to shoot a three. Can he make it? Yes. 99-96. I believe that's 24 points for Wally McGee. And here we go. They are going to run it down the floor. No timeouts left. Chance for three. They've got to put it up. They got to put it up. There it is. No, it's off the rim. Rebound, Gorgui Dieng. And it is a third straight victory for the Minnesota Timberwolves. It wasn't easy, but they are able to get it on their home court against the Indiana Pacers. A hard-fought win, and the youngsters are starting to gain some confidence. Speaking of youngsters, I think we should go talk to Wally McGee about the big victory tonight.
Congratulations on the win and leading the way in terms of the points production. How were you able to create shots for yourself?
I think I was just trying my hardest to sell every fake I threw. A lot of times you can just go through the motions with stuff, but if you work hard to sell a fake, you can open up space like I was able to. Yo, I can make a living in Hollywood with my acting skills, you know what I'm saying?
Albeit grudgingly, I will admit tonight you were the master puppeteer. Kevin, over to you.
They really have to fix those courtside interviews so you can actually hear them over the blaring music. It's kind of unfortunate. You think they would have leveled that out. But anyway, speaking of leveling out, we go up another level on Athlete to level 8. And he's now, well, still a 75 overall. And next up is the Oklahoma City Thunder. We got to go on the road. That'll be an impressive win if we're able to move it to 4 straight against those guys. We'll see you next time for more Wally McGee.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Subscribe right here on YouTube to get daily videos from SGU, as well as frequent live streaming events. Give us a follow on Twitter for up-to-the-minute information on channel uploads. And last but not least, check out the SGU Facebook page. So what are you waiting for? Join in on the fun today!